snowstorm. Pretty interesting considering we're meant to be going racing in like 4 hours or 5 hours or something. Pretty interesting spot to be in right now, but you know, fingers crossed that it clears as we get further down the country. So the weather's taken a bit of a swing, and snow on the desert road to kind of, I wouldn't call it clear skies, but it's there's enough clear sky to go racing now, so that's a positive thing. So we're here at Palmerston North for the first night of 3 nights. So we're here for 2 nights, then we go to Harrisville on Sunday. So pretty busy 3 days, and it also means we're going to have to race a little bit with our heads too, you know. Long weekend of racing, so we've got to be there for Sunday as well, not just first heat tonight. So tonight is a normal thing, two heats, front reverse, then a 30 lap feature, so fairly simple format. And then for the top, I think top six qualifiers are going to have a little bit of a shootout thing. So once we kind of get through our heats, we know whether we're in that little dash deal or not, and go from there. But yeah, glad that the weather's kind of turned around, being that, like you saw before, we had some snow on desert road. That's a first for sure.
Thank you.
super short turnaround between heat one and heat two, but picked up the win, which is a good one from six, so bagged some big points then. It was pretty brave stuff up on the top. A couple of times I got up around Ben Matthews and left just enough space, and I was like running down the wall as well, kind of rubbing wheels too, so big balls thing it was, that kind of a line to run, but we made it work and pulled it off, so got the win and bagged a good amount of points in heat one. Got off to a reasonable start, started to think about picking some cars off, and then ended up in a bit of a car park, as you can see. Carlos ended up in it, we ended up in it, and Jaden down the far end, he ended up in it as well. So it was unfortunate on that part. It looked like up ahead, well, you'll probably see in the footage a lot better, I might even slow-mo it, that you'd just see a car up ahead of us, and that was kind of in the fluff, and obviously he ended up turned over in the end, but by the time we realised he was turned over and stopped on the track, it was too late to try and get out of it. And Jaden ended up piled in, and I ended up basically piled into Jaden, and then about another 10 cars it seemed like followed us in. So should be some good camera footage from that one, but we were super lucky to get away unscathed with that. Like, we just tore up a tail bar, and which I obviously just pushed into the tail tank just a little bit, so got away pretty scotch-free, and ready to roll on for the feature. I think we even finished fourth or fifth in the end, I think, so I was unsure with just the scrap mad scramble at the end to where everyone ended up, but yeah, like I say, kind of got a fairly cleanish car, which is a good thing, so time to roll into the 30 lap feature. slow 30 laps to get started, but once it got rolling, it
nice race,
ticked, over, ticked over pretty fast. So ended up rolling home fourth in the end. Pretty much I just put the whole lot down to it. We probably had a podium until I decided, I thought the rubber was down on the bottom, so I went down probably maybe 2-3 laps earlier than I should have. I probably should have put assisted with the top and then locked it down on the bottom. When I got there, it had kind of not fully laid in yet and didn't do a good enough job. We were just early on it, and then Ben snuck around the outside of us, so I got back to the top and then pounded that for a bit more. And you know, the irony is when Ben snuck by is when I probably should have almost just started to be on it, or started to look to get on it. So yeah, a bit of a mistake on my part in reading the race and reading the track as it evolved. But hey, that's exactly what the sport's all about. You know, it's more than just standing on the gas. It's kind of looking at what's going on around it. Happy with the result? Well, I'd say mild, yes. You know, I know where we made mistakes. I know where we can improve. Like, we did pretty good tire wise, so it tells me we're probably pretty safe on tire wear. But especially looking at some of the other cars that are, how their tires are worn, so probably could have been and maybe a little bit more aggressive running it through the bottom on the rubber as well. So all food for thought and just stuff to remember. So all in all, good night in the 9M spike. So yeah, we obviously given it all a bit of a bath now. Get the panels cleaned up, and that's just one job. So tomorrow when we come in and start doing maintenance, we just probably give the car a bit of a rag down and a blow off, and charge the battery, grease the bars, and good to go again. So all in all, not a bad night, and straight car in the end of it all. So rolled it on the trailer and start it all again tomorrow.